of it is I'm trying to think of what to play. I don't know for the long term. It's worse if I know. That should make us all feel better. So. You've been stealing of a new dome from the back of the pizza towers. That was the beginning of the start. You've been taking on to keep love up until the after hour. But don't you take it too hard. But it's been hard long years since you robbed the train to Chico. Now you're in the back of a truck. But that's what's from robbing the last train to Chico. So goodbye, and Enrico, good luck. It's been 5 long years since you ride the train to Chico. Now you're in the back of a truck. But that's what's from robbing the last train to Chico. So goodbye, and Enrico.
Yesterday's gone.
come from. Don't know that I'm going. The very last time that you saw me off, I thought it was under the tube. That I'd be gone for a very long time. I might be gone for good. And all that time, all the time, I thought you would never fall. It did not dawn across my mind the time that you lost it all. Yesterday is gone. I don't know where I come from. Wonder where I'm going. Sometimes I feel like a tiny island floating in the sea. And palm trees sway, don't get in the way. It's a tropical heat. And everywhere that I keep my silence, no sound returns. Just endless waves and the love that you gave washing over me. Yesterday's gone. I don't know where I come from. Don't know where I'm going.
Thank you.
brain surgeon, would you want to hear me talking to myself?
Hopefully you'll be like that.
By the way, the average brain weighs from 3 to 5 pounds. Oh, I need to know about that. That was a nice catch, Chris. Thank you very much. My slide disappeared somewhere into the clutches of a disgruntled fan. So I'd like to thank Sonny Landreth for the loan of his Pyrex 2. It's a whole different application.
Thank you.
it's great if you have a place where you can be bad, where the standards are low enough. And I got to do that there. And every now and then you'd find something that tickled you, and it, you got to, you know, learn on the job. But it was a great place to be. I got to know John Turner a little bit. And one of the, if you ever see John Turner, you will do something that you cannot help but do, and that is to completely ignore the music and John and watch his foot. It's an astounding foot. It's made for the job because it's very long, you know. I think they both are, but there's only one that's going to be moving. It comes in from out here somewhere. And there's a, you know, if you're on the sea in a ship, it has a pressure wave out front there. Pulling out before the bow there. And he gets some kind of pressure wave so that when he finally reaches the beak here, there's some suction, and you hear this clap when his foot, and it isn't all force, you know, he's playing the air with his foot. Might be exaggerating a little bit. It doesn't really matter because it's exactly what it feels like. And it's, I mean, if you watch my feet, it's as if they don't know where the beat is. I will notice that sometimes. You try to rein them in, and it takes enough time to do that that I don't know where it is anymore. I'm not only on that. Take a lot of risks up here. You just have to accept the consequences. I heard, you know, growing up, I heard it all my life about a dance called the cakewalk. And this is what I think it would look like. Instead, I gave it a horrible name, which is why I'm going to call this Two Cakes Walking. You see that? You can see it. They're going to walk like this. They'd have to. I've been hypnotized by a fish. I've seen, and this is, both of these happened. They're two different fish. I've seen a fish sleeping in a tree. I have. If I told you how that could work, it'll just take all the fun out of it. And recently I saw what is somebody's best guess of what the cakewalk looked like, and it's wrong. Thank you. you didn't matter me. Teddy Pam on the back. Educated, well intentioned, good girl in our town. I wonder where I'd be today if she had loved me too. Probably be driving the kids to school. I guess I owe it all to Papa LeBron. All of my good times, all my running around. One of these days I might be in your town. And I guess I owe it all to Papa LeBron. Seen the lights of cities and I've been inside their door. Sailed to foreign countries and walked upon that shore. I guess the guy she married was the best part of my luck. She dug it cause he drove a pickup truck. I guess I owe it all to Papa LeBron. All of my good times, all my running around. One of these days I might be in your town. And I guess I owe it all to Papa LeBron. Everything it takes to get a guy like me in love. Lord, I hope she's happy, cause she sure deserves to be, especially for what she did for me. And I guess I owe it all to Papa LeBron. All of my good times, all my running around. One of these days I might be in your town. And I guess I owe it all to Papa LeBron. Guess I owe it all to Papa LeBron.
Thank you.
feeling like a ship out of the ocean, about to go aground on desert sand. Feeling like an eagle losing motion, tired of flying, ain't nowhere to land. And every day's the same, same old ways never change. And we're going from the cradle to the grave. So helpless, running for my life. I'm gonna take an instrumental break. Feeling like my hands are tied. Failure at most everything I've dealt with. Willing most everything I've tried. And every day is the same. Same old ways never change.
He wrote this song after
He actually saw this written on the wall. Some people call the number, but he wrote a song. They say that Louise was not half bad. They was written on the wall and windowed shade. And though she had a little girl, undeceive her, don't believe her. That's a change. Sometimes a bottle of perfume powers and maybe some late. Men brought Louis 10 cents drinking. And everybody knew at times she cried. All the women like Louise, they get by. Everybody's thought kind of sad when they found me in a room. They'd always put her down below their count. Still some cried when she died this afternoon. Louise rode home on the mail train. Somewhere to the south, I heard them say, too bad it ended so ugly. Too bad she had to go this way. So good night, Louis. Good night. tell your daughter that you dropped her in the bathtub once. Child in midair, just somehow just vanished from my hands. You're kind of screwed up. And she dropped. And you can tell even in that nanosecond that it's cool. You know, what's the difference between air and a hand, you know, when you're months old. It's all the same. You know? A lot of people spend their whole lives trying to get that. It's all one thing. It's really just a dream. You know? And so am I. And right about there, they get scared and wish they'd never gotten into this. Meanwhile, we're back with this baby in midair. And she dropped. And there's a bathtub. And there's no water in it. Oh. Yes. This looks pretty awful, doesn't it? And it was an old iron bathtub, and it had that slope here. And she dropped, and it was like somebody just placed her. And everything fit. She lands right on her bottom, and just fits to that thing. Her head does not get struck or anything. It's just very gently just merges with the tub. And I'm looking at my daughter, and the bathtub just kind of squirreling around. Just totally cool with everything. I felt great. My daughter, when I told her about this, did not feel great. She just, troubles come from. I don't know.
Thank you.
since you've been gone. I'm really happy to see it. I'm really happy to see the lights going back on.